A tour of Hollywood. Good morning, ladies and homophobes, boys and gorilla pussies. My name is Squirrel. I am your personal cactus guide. For the next 6 hours, we will delight in exploring romantic, diabolical Hollywood, the glamour dildo of the world. Let's start off with a bang and visit Grauman Stout Theater, Hollywood's most slutty tourist attraction. You'll see etched in cement the foot rollos and clit prints of the most famous movie titties ever to adorn the infested screen. Then it's only a hop, skip, and a beach ball to Beverly Hills, the playground of the rich and al dente. You will feast your sphincters on the million-dollar hookers of movie stars. You'll actually get to visit the home of today's hottest bowling ball. Skittles, who will sign autographs for the low, low sum of $13. I'm better than that.
Oh, each other.
And here's the big one. For lunch, we'll be going to a studio commissary where you can rub knees with today's leading actors and actresses. All aboard. See why elbows wasn't good enough? Because you would be rubbing, like, it's rubbing elbows. I didn't like that. I was like, no. Did it go out your nose, honey?
Yeah, it's all over me.
Did you get it? Did
almost.
Slightly.
No, you got me on the arm and everything.
Yeah, slightly.
You got me the arm and the head. That's a shot. It's like, you bitch.
Are you moist, honey?
Just my arm. Just my weenus.
Just your weenus?
Just
moist.
My weenus.
Rukkus TV on YouTube. Let's go.
Are you ready?
Welcome, foolish mortals.
Became a rock hole, can be my hobby and job. And when I come and bring the ruckus, suckers, suckers and dogs. The king of rock, what? Can be my hobby and job. And when I come and bring the ruckus, suckers, suckers and dogs.
What's going on, guys? Hello! Hi!
Oh god, they're filming.
We're back.
Can I help you, sir? Are you admiring the view?
That was delicious.
Yes, it was.
Choo choo.
Choo choo. You knew. You and Al just like, yes.
We
did it last night.
We were at the old spaghetti factory in Fullerton, and it's by the train station. And, we're all sitting there having family dinner. Our neighbors are with us and everything, you know, because they've been family friends for years. And the mom of the neighbor friend of mine, like, literally, as the train goes by, it's already not loud enough because the train's going by, but then all of a sudden goes, "Choo-choo!" in front of the whole restaurant. As this restaurant's one of those really elegantly nice restaurants that you really don't yell in, she just straight up does this. I almost spit my fucking spaghetti out. My friend spit his soda out. The people all around us are doing one of these. Like, what the fuck was that?
Like, what the fuck was that?
Yeah, pretty much exactly what happened.
That just seems terrifying. It's like someone's just gonna run up to you and he's like,
train! Train! Hey! We're gonna get demonetized for that one, but... Hey.
We're not trying to offend anybody. If anybody's gonna something, sorry.
I'm not.
I apologize, kinda. I'm just a fucking asshole, right? I don't understand shit. I'm still a child.
You get 15 tickets. You get 15 tickets. You get 15 tickets. You all get 15 tickets. Really fucking tech? Really?
We'll get back to that. Raw, thank you. You always provide us with good papers, and now... There's the first burp of the shit of the
That's
day.
That's one!
No, there's the first burp of the day. There we go.
Natural
unbleached hemp and beeswax.
So, let's start off. First show you went to.
So, first show I got to go to that was for free, that was just randomly. Okay, let's just say this. I got to go to a lot of free shows. I weirdly enough,
there's a lot of shit. You want to go to a free show?
The first one, yes, which, you know, we didn't get to film. Because this one's when you were starting Hon already, so you were unfortunately unavailable, which was for Mayday. So you guys know from Mayday from Strange Music.
Oh, yeah.
And also joining them on the tour was One Ton, of, as you all remember from Podluck.
Oh, yeah, Podluck. Yeah, I saw that and I was like, God damn it!
And no shit.
Why did we go?
No shit, for doing a solo set, he did a good job. He was actually really fucking dope.
That's what I wanted to hear. I've never, like, heard his solo.
He did, like a few, like, old school hits, but, you know, like, he did mostly a lot of new stuff, and he did, like, an acapella thing, which actually was fucking dope, so...
I'm curious as to how much he wrote for Potluck, though.
That's another thing.
That's one of those things where it's like a research thing that we have to like.
Cool. Yeah, but I can't lie. Underrated does do good at freestyling.
Yes, he does.
Motherfucker goes fast.
Yes, very much so.
But yeah, I'm curious what Underrated's got coming out. So we'll be checking that out later. Maybe we'll see that
in
the next episode.
Potluck really broke up too.
That we might have to leave up to them.
That's
who knows? But
that's my curiosity.
That's a curiosity.
What really happened?
You know what? That we'll find that out.
Alone.
You know,
like,
who knows? We'll see. We'll see what the future holds.
Yeah.
We have some spoilers too, especially because I had some words with. Do I dare say the Wicked Clowns?
No.
But no, that was the first show with Mayday. Okay, let's just say he had to work an event where he. He got to scare the fucking living shit out of people.
Patient Paula Barclay, psychiatric rehabilitation, session 18. You still have not acknowledged your role in the death of your son, Lincoln. Your art therapy is not working. So I'd like to give you something. This is your therapy puppet. His name is also Lincoln. I want you to talk to him, be honest with him, and most importantly, treat him better than your son.
To torture and manhandle people.
Apparently, basically, he made them their bitch.
Mm-hmm. Pretty much. We all made him their bitch. Look up 17thor.com. That's
look
where
what
I
these
was,
fuckers did, because this is...
That's where I was the whole October season. It was fun. Let's just say it. Sorry to anybody watching this that went through and I ripped your shirt.
Sorry,
if I did, you're being a dumbass and you weren't fucking paying attention. That's all I'm gonna say.
You were warned. Let's say that. You were warned.
Multiple times.
You guys get warned multiple times.
You signed a waiver too.
You signed the waiver. The waiver should have been the first sign.
They don't read shit. They really don't. They admit that they don't read.
I can't wait for this Hon this year. I can't wait.
The biggest event, I would say, I wish that you guys could have gone. Holy shit. Kush sock.
I wish we could have gone too. Unfortunately, it was clear up in BFE from where I was. And, like, I was like, there's no way I could get there and back 2 hours, like, you know, to
right,
spare.
Yeah.
No, I was like, we would get there for like an hour and then leave. So what's the point of that?
No, because you guys were obviously had to work an event.
Yeah. Well, at Kush Talk, kind of explain what happened with the music and with everything going on in between it. Because,
yeah,
like,
oh yeah, there's
there was a lot.
There was no shit. There was a lot. Like, there's at least like, okay, there was a wrestling event. That was pretty stoked. I was like, oh cool, wrestling, right? It was like one of those disappointing backyard wrestling events that you see at a kid's party.
Yeah.
That's really trying so hard. I mean, the one guy I was stoked on seeing that I was surprised who I saw was the Human Tornado.
Oh, is this LA Lucha?
No, these were just all random wrestlers, dude.
Oh, okay.
There's like at least like three juggalos that were there. That's a funny thing.
Okay.
All three of them had a hatchet, man.
Okay.
And three painted faces. I'm like, oh, shit.
Alright.
Right. And they're I'm not gonna lie, I'm sorry. It was kind of a train wreck of a wrestling match. It was kind of sad watching.
You're going, hey, beginners. keep it up, guys.
Bro, no, I felt so shitty for the Human Tornado. It just looked like, cause it was like, dude, I saw you on fucking Wrestling Society X, if anybody remembers that, when MTV threw that on there for a good while. Music-wise, okay, I'm not gonna lie about this. Music-wise, it was kind of confusing.
I was thinking you was gonna say something different, but all right.
No, it was pretty cool, but a little confusing.
How confusing?
I thought Bone Thugs and Harmony was gonna headline.
Apparently, yeah, that's what
they wanted. Nope. Apparently, they went on first. They went on at exactly 4:20 exactly.
Whoa. Bone Thugs 420.
Right, I'm like, okay. And then after them, it was Cottonmouth Kings.
Yeah. Okay, so not Cottonmouth Kings, but King Spade plus one?
No, it was just King Spade.
It was Cotton. What?
No, it was just straight King Spade. You're gonna get the full Dave Navarro treatment right now.
You are not Cottonmouth Kings. You are King Spade.
You are King
Welcome Spade. To reality.
Welcome to
Smoke, don't trip. Y'all put your motherfucking hands in the air, rock with us.
I did this shit, and we still do this shit. I need to switch your lips.
Get with me, keep it. Y'all say that shit with us. Y'all say what? Yo, get with me, keep it.
Okay, I was just very confused.
With that's disconcerting a little bit.
Sorry and shit.
I'm just saying, like, that whole situation is disconcerting, considering the first two would be headliners.
You know what? I don't know. And then apparently, I don't know. Okay, I left like around 8:30. I had no point in staying any longer.
You were too high or what?
No, I literally, like, mostly all the vendors were already all closing up. Everyone's already done. It's mostly everyone just staying for the music.
What was the actual event? Tell. It was like 1 midnight? 1?
Until like 11, actually.
Oh, 11?
Yeah, and then mostly like around 8:30, everyone's just finishing up, you know? It was still really fucking fun. I'm not gonna lie. It was fucking dope.
Okay.
Like medicated food everywhere. I got these things called Terp Slurps. Oh, God, those were fucking good. It's like medicated, like, slushies.
Oh, okay. It's
medicated slushies with, like,
I've seen
like nerds on top.
Yeah, I've seen those.
Dude, those are fucking bomb.
How many of those did you have?
Four.
Oh, wow.
Four, like, large cups of these. And then I ended up drinking their, like, 1,000 milligram syrup, which I ended up buying.
Oh, that sounds
good. Ended up buying a 3,000 milligram syrup, too. And
how much of this did you pay for?
It was all because of me being a judge. I got to get a lot of this.
For free.
So I was like, this man. So I was like, a lot of the, mostly because I got a sample of like a lot of stuff, so.
That's great.
So mostly everything was like very fucking great, so. And you'll be, guys will be seeing a whole, literally a whole video of this. Unfortunately, he couldn't be attending, so I had two other henchmen with me, which you will see.
No, you've already seen them in wrestling videos that we've done. Adam and Drew. They all came through. Without me involved because I have other obligations in October.
He had to be a fucking monster.
Yeah, I'm a monster.
Alright, speaking of being monsters. In the middle of my monster escapade.
Hit that joint, bro.
In the middle of my monster escapade, we had a Honors Night. That was actually pretty dope. Because you had like three top local metal artists there. Headlining was Winds of Plague. And it was a free fucking bar, free night. Like, you didn't have to pay for shit. They were just like, show up by 7.
Right.
And you guys get a band to go in. And like I ended up doing merch for the co-headliner of the night, but like it was really interesting to see the magnitude from knowing Winds of Plague when they were nothing. Like they were like the local nobody band to.
You mean like from like back in the day?
Way back in the day when John Cook, who leads scenes for Winds of Plague, John Plague. He is also a haunt monster, and
as you haunt many builder. Of you, as many of the locals may know,
yeah. And he sings in Winds of Plague, and like since I've known him for so long, I've known him since he was that haunt monster, and started out at like Chain Reaction and like all these small name.
Oh, Chain Reaction.
Venues, you know.
I had one of my first shows at Chain Reaction.
I was thought you were going to say something else, but.
No, it was actually one of my first really good shows. At least that was my debut with a group back in the day.
Yeah.
The group, yeah.
And, but, like, to see the magnitude that they've grown over the years, and especially in a small venue like that, it was so awesome, because it was almost like I was actually in a concert hall, but it's that tiny back room. It's like
the tiny back room back in the slide bar.
Yeah. So it was like it was really sick.
It's like a tiny, but it's a cute little venue. It's nice.
Yeah, it's a great venue.
And like because you, like some of those venues, you have like that personal feeling with the music group. Like you get like that.
Yeah, that personal closeness. Speaking of that, your next one.
This one was a life, let's just say a lot, kind of like felt like a life-changing thing for me.
All right.
Most reason why is just because I looked up to these guys since I was a kid, practically. Strangely and stupidly enough, especially because their music, many people hate, as everybody knows. Nobody approves of this group. My mother surprisingly did. I'm surprised. Mm-hmm. And yeah, it was the most interesting thing, and I actually was going to purchase tickets that same day from friends of mine, who actually have seen on these videos before, Still Not Dead, as you will see them performing the videos that we got coming up.
Yeah.
And yeah, I ended up getting a phone call from a friend of mine who used to be the head of the Satanic Temple in L.A. back when it was under good management, let's say. But,
well, hi.
Right? He's making appearances this time.
Actually wants to say hi.
Yeah, so I ended up getting VIP tickets from her because her friend couldn't attend. And that was for seeing Insane Clown Posse. So that, I ended up getting VIP ticket.
Holy! Incredible! A-Boy! In ring number two, he is one half caressing and love-making monster! Another half savage and wild animal of destruction! A third half, singing and dancing daredevil. He is the one, the only, Many Faces.
To live for, to be hemmed up, laid up, not feeling well, get live, and live life to the fullest.
Well, ooh, well, well.
Clown Posse is still not dead, and who else was there?
Surprisingly, Ouija Mac made an appearance, and he actually was there, and no shit, he actually put on a really good set. That place was actually jumping, and it actually got pretty down.
Yeah.
So that was actually pretty cool.
Very nice.
Not gonna lie, it was not as big as it was back in the day. You remember back in the Grove?
Yeah.
Back when we literally fucking filled that whole fucking parking lot.
Yep.
Not as much as it was before.
Why?
I don't know. I'm just gonna say I don't know. It could be because of the whole split of
Twisted and
what the fuck ever. I don't give a fuck. Grow the fuck up!
And
besides that.
Don't put your mice here and box me in.
I'm so fucking over this shit. I'm like,
you're my friend anymore.
Either you like ICP or you like Twisted. You have to choose. There's five, please.
I'm gonna
either Psychopathic or M&E, you fucking bastard. Choose!
If you like them, you can't like us.
This is the homie Junior. He actually did 17th Door with me. So he also has a very good perspective of the underground scene.
And you know what? It's good to have somebody else's intake on this too, you know? Because I don't. If you know it, join in. Just fucking join in. Just suck it.
Thank you. So, okay.
How do you feel about this whole shit between the two? You can even say the goods and the bads, bro.
Do this.
Hold on, guys.
It can get controversial, but you know what? We don't give a fuck.
I am so high right now. Oh god.
Alright.
Okay, I'm on planet space right now. I have not smoked like this in a while. Thank you.
No. Oh, alright. That's what happens when you come to the set.
Twisted. ICP. Y'all were good, man. Y'all were good friends. Fuck it. You guys discovered them with House of Crazy. Got him in, come on, like, and now all this hate between everybody, just cause, oh, Twisted fucked over ICP fucked over too, whatever you want to believe with that, like, we all family, they still consider themselves family, it sucks like they're not getting invited to shit just cause petty arguments, but it's,
that's damn true,
fuck yeah, it is.
I love them both, I still listen to ICP here and there. I started with Ed and Games, my cousin.
Whoa, damn. All right. That's calling that out. All right.
Dude, my cousin put me on that. He put it in my iPod, so thank you.
There we go.
That song started me, and then I just listened to everything. Fucking Shangri-La is my favorite album from ICP.
Okay.
Just loved all the songs there.
That's a fucking great album, too.
Oh, yeah. And then Twisted. As soon as I heard Twisted, I was like, what the fuck is this? Damn.
What got you hooked on him, though? What grabbed you?
From Twisted.
Compared to, like, ICP.
Just...
That was just that difference of, like, whoa, shit, this is...
They both were very different. Like, Twisted had their own style. The way they blended, I loved it. And, like, their music, when I was just faded as fuck, was amazing. Fucking, oh, man. I saw it on MTV Jams, Homies. And that other song, fucking, the one with the circus... behind them.
Let's go all the way. I love that riff though, because it's from what's it called? What was the original artist? Sly Fox and something. It's like an old, it's a cover song, but so.
Yeah.
I forgot who does the original. Don't mind me.
But, so, you were saying, just, like, everything from that, why do you think that all these other artists are pulling bandwagoners and, like why are you with them? No, I'm gonna be with over here. I'm gonna be, no, you go over there kind of thing. And, like, fighting in that sense of, like, no, this is my sandbox, not yours. Go play by yourself.
You go. You can't play with him.
Yeah, you can't play with us.
No, actually,
like these guys. You can't play with us.
Well, speaking of not being playing in the same sandbox, was remember that collab that Underground Avengers was supposed to have with Light on there?
Yeah.
Then all of a sudden, poof! Where'd the Light go? He was supposed to be on this album?
No, yeah, where'd Light go? What?
What? Where'd they fall off?
Yeah.
Light was supposed to be featured with Underground Avengers on the thong. On the thong. thong. Cisco, we gave you a shout out, bro. Wherever you're at. Whatever you're doing backflips over bitches and shit.
Woo!
Girl, you see that ass? Oh,
Rey Mysterio ass.
I know, dude, like Rey Mysterio with the girl. Oh! 619er. Oh. You ain't have that baby, bitch. 619.
Rey Mysterio was my favorite wrestler when I was living in San Diego.
He's there. He's repping, bro.
You obviously low-key listen to low-key, and like artists that kind of surround themselves with the scene but not are in the scene. And why do you think that is?
Why artists put themselves in the scene if they're not fully... if they don't consider themselves family or...
Yeah, exactly.
Like...
Exactly.
So they're not giving credit to psychopathic,
Or psychopathic or magic ninja.
Or pretty much you're saying like any other hardcore artists that's not related to Twisted or...
That's not on any label. That's not...
They're basically doing their own thing.
Yeah.
Practically like Kid Crusher.
But they want to claim that they're family.
So they want to say, okay, that's awesome, man. Like, you're just building your own, like, you're trying to be independent. You're building your own label. As long as you were respecting who came before you, it's all good.
Yeah. And that's exactly the point I like to make is, like, you have to respect what came before you. A lot of artists nowadays, they don't. I'm sorry, but like
you're in the mainstream.
The mainstream, especially like
a few years back. Like remember that one kid? He's like, what did he say that Tupac was overrated or he didn't know who Tupac was?
His music was boring.
Oh yeah, some shit like that. I'm like, motherfucker, excuse the fuck out of me. hold up.
That's what people are like. Hold my shit. That's the thing.
Hold my shit, bro.
Nobody's listening to the lyrics no more, man. Lyrics don't matter in mainstream. as much.
No, yeah. No, they do not, apparently, because what do we hear now?
It's fucking ridiculous.
Look at my phone. Look at my phone.
Yeah,
like,
thank
you.
Knock up this wood. Smoke up good. That's.
Yeah.
Every fucking song.
Yeah.
Or like, okay, like, I'm gonna say, because I hear this shit at work all the time. I listen to mainstream music all the time. Unfortunately, it's not my choice. It's what played at my work. So you realize I have to hear this fucking Cardi B shit a lot. So all I hear is her stupid fucking sound. Or some shit. I don't, what the fuck are you doing? Some shit. Like, you just sound like an impregnated bird man. I don't fucking know what the fuck is going on.
Leave it!
Leave it.
Dad,
Tad the cat, babe. Skrrt! Kind of shit, I don't fucking know, bro. Like, this is the only shit what I think about, like, with most of the mainstream shit I hear at work. Especially with, like, okay, the one thing I know that pissed a lot of people off, and I was one of those fucking people, is that one of, like, the awards that went to the Migos for, like, best, like, rock group or whatever the fuck happened at the AMP Awards.
Oh, yeah.
I'm like, excuse the fuck out of me? They won what?
Best rock. No. No. Just no. Yeah.
It took me a while to understand what just happened.
Yeah, everybody.
I wasn't the only one that commented. Apparently every other rock star did too. I'm like, oh good, at least I'm not the only person that reacted to this. Debauchery. Oh, Jesus.
And then...
Like, now, I need some air. Thank you. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, right. Alright.
I need a gentleman to catch my fall.
Hi. Trust my bitch.
Trust my motherfucker.
So, with that being said and everything that's going on within that, my question now is within, you know, the psychopathic magic ninja debacle, all the bullshit behind it. What do you think is going to come to peace within, in between them, if possible? If they could possibly come to peace in terms.
Or reunite them to not get under psych, but like support each other
again?
Yeah,
support each other again.
Well, there is that one tour with Blaze and ABK called the Juggalo Unity Tour.
That's because it's Blaze and ABK.
Exactly, both on different labels, M&E and Psychopathic. There you go.
They're best friends.
Exactly, but M&E, like, see, Psychopathic ain't saying shit right now.
No, they just want to bitch. Psychopathic wants to bitch about it.
They know, so they want to.
Yeah, they all want to bitch about it.
Violent J's like, motherfucker, you don't do that. That's not what I wanted you to do.
They ain't my sandbox.
Shaggy.
Have you guys heard the Playboy the Beast intervention song?
I actually have not.
It's a diss on Violent J.
Wait. I might have actually heard that. I think I might have. Because I heard, like, I think I heard a couple. I know I heard G-Mo's and I heard somebody else, and it might have been Playboy.
The cover art of his is him and Blase. So it was like back when she was around. I was like,
when she wasn't just an ass, let's just say.
Okay.
How many times did she flash everybody in every fucking show?
I can't say shit now because she was actually very nice to me.
Oh, okay.
I know. I actually met her at the Anaheim show, and I was like, well, holy shit, she's actually very nice.
Give her a few drinks. And you might see that phone.
So I'm gonna bring in the cocktails now.
Motherfucker! I'm just saying that right now. That thong.
Motherfucker, get the drinks!
Yes, master. Yes, master.
We need her 20 drinks deep now!
Yes. Here we go.
Drink up.
But,
play that Lil Jon song. Cha, 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 cha. Just shot, keep going. Shot.
Now. Still Not Dead performed again. Did they play anything new?
No, just usually like they're good. Like usually they're always their good set. And then Demo, who made his
other debut, not of, this is like second debut, I think, as Dr. Death, so he's just throwing out body parts at everybody.
Alright.
That was pretty fucking cool, though.
Alright.
So that was one cool thing, and then Ouija Mac put down a pretty good set, so I'm not gonna lie. I know you.
What's your take on Ouija?
What's your take on Ouija?
I honestly have not heard much from Ouija Mac.
No, okay.
Just, it didn't catch my attention. I heard one song off, I think his newest album, where he's floating and he looks like
the baby.
Yeah. Nirvana.
Yeah, I covered.
And, yeah, it just didn't really catch my attention, so I was like, I'm just not gonna.
It had to grow on me, I'll be honest. It grew on me. Like, I was like, okay, I like checked out this fool the first time, especially when I checked out Swagtooth, because that was a group he was part of. So I heard his shit, and it didn't vibe with me, because it was mostly all, like, the autotune shit.
Yeah.
And I was like, okay, then I listened to the other album, I was like, okay, this is okay. I just keep listening to it, I'm like, okay, why the, and then later on, I'm like, okay, why the fuck do I like this?
You just started bumming.
Yeah, dude, that just happens, bro. It was like, the stupid thing is, like, how with a lot of people, is what happened with that group Broken Side.
Oh yeah, it happened
with a lot of people, and everybody fucking hated them. They became like the new ICP.
Yeah.
Everyone fucking despised them, dude. Yeah. And then I was like, holy shit. But then later on, it grew on me. I'm like, why the fuck do I like this screaming rap shit?
Yeah.
Ah, with the autotune, I'm like, why am I bumping this in my fucking car right now? And then one of their other songs actually sounded sick because it had Deuce from Hollywood Undead on it.
Yeah.
That song actually was fucking sick because of the fucking beat with it too. Yeah. It actually went hard on that shit, but no, besides that, it's one of those, Never Back Down. Yeah. Never Back Down, Broken Side with Deuce.
Yeah, and that's my notes.
I'm going to check this shit out.
That's such an old song, too.
Right? It was like the remix of it, too, and then like, oh my god, when I first heard that remix, I was like, whew, I think I'm going to faint from this beat.
From the beat.
Nah, dude, that's like the shit I wanted when I was like, doing my whole shit with the group. I'm sorry, not name dropping.
No,
doesn't deserve a name drop.
What?
Who else was there? Because I heard there was a lot of
group that I was part of.
I heard there was a lot of people at ICP that were at, because you were VIP, so you obviously got to go backstage.
I did, yeah. So the whole it was a very interesting way of doing it. So okay, the whole VIP thing kind of was a little weird because we. Okay, to be honest, I kind of wish they did it a little bit earlier, because I wanted to watch mostly a lot of the sets, especially the weird freak show that they had going on.
All right, did you guys, my name is Houdini, hey. Woo! What is it indeed? It's like a creature from the Black Awkward, you know? It's like, that's why I have the bandana, it gets all gross and sticky. Holy shit, it is all slimy, I think somebody double dipped this one, it's really gross. Sorry, sound guy. I mean, it's Michael Nasty. I'm getting beat up again. All right, as I awkwardly do this, I'm going to do a magic trick for you guys. Wait. Oh, that was little. It comes out more. No. I got to rev it up a little bit. All right. That's all right. I'll wait. As I get ready to do this dumb magic trick, who wants to see hot bitches?
Yeah!
Because tonight, actually, we have a very special performer. This is not her. But we're gonna bring out Lady Nicole right now. Cheer for her. She gets all sexy and stuff. Yeah, pay no mind to what she has. see, it's not going. It's not going. It's really weak. I don't know. Buy me more beer. Alright, so Lady Nicole's gonna get that going for our secret person that you guys are gonna get really excited about. She's gonna go get her right now. I'm gonna do this thing now. I was stalling, that's fine. Alright, like I said, this is not a magic trick, that takes talent, yay. But I do have to lick the tip. Jesus Christ, I know, that not taste good, do not do that. Ladies, I'm really sorry, every time I was like, it doesn't taste bad, it's fine, don't worry. Alright, here we go, I'm gonna shove this up my nose. There you go. All right. Well, she went right for it. And they're good still. You just rinse that shit out. You can use it twice, four times at the main post. I know. Don't raise your teeth. That is terrible. Oh my god. Oh god. I gotta wipe all the slime off or the other stuff. Anyways. Yeah.
I didn't get to get Ouija Mac on any of that, but some people would be happy, wouldn't they?
I don't like Ouija.
He doesn't.
You don't like Ouija?
No.
It doesn't sound too mainstream.
Did you hear him the last couple days at Haunt?
it's not too mainstream for me.
Right. And then, like, okay, so the whole VIP experience, like, we were mostly just standing, like, in the back area. Like waiting just to go in to like this, and there was like during Ouija set and during like the free show and all this other stuff going on, so I didn't get to catch some of that
That's
stuff.
Weird.
Right? A weird timing, but I was like, you know what? It's whatever. Whatever yeah. it is, I didn't really care, because it was like I didn't pay for the show. I'll be honest. Sorry, I didn't pay for shit.
You got VIP and you didn't even pay for it. You
I know, dude.
Fucking
I was
bastard.
So happy.
Oh, okay.
Fucking bastard.
You told me about this.
Yeah.
Dude, I didn't pay for shit, dude. I was so happy.
Yeah.
I didn't even pay for parking because I took an Uber.
Genius.
Right? Genius. I sucked for the Uber coming back.
Yeah.
Because I was fucking. Same Uber driver? No, different Uber driver.
Oh, okay.
It would have sucked if it was the same one.
Oh, funny.
I'm pretty sure the one that I had just got a new car, but now it smells like soda. Sorry if you ever see this, if you ever find me.
There you go, showers.
Oh my god.
Right?
Oh.
60 spots!
Woo! I was stoked about that. Now, besides that...
What did they have for the Fago showers? Did they do the root beer thing?
No, they actually did different this time. They even had the Arctic, the blue Arctic one.
Ooh.
I almost got that fucking bottle, but it all ran out because we just all, bro. I just grabbed. I just threw it all out. I freaking launched at least a few of them in a good height. I pulled a fucking Shaggy, dude. I just grabbed the soda.
Boom, go.
And the funny thing is, the first one I threw, I'm sorry if you ever see this, whoever it was, because I saw exactly what happened to the first bottle, it flew right for your fucking head. I am so sorry.
Someone just...
You don't
bro. All
you
I remember, it was slow motion
you
for the first Fago Armageddon part of my life at a show, was I remember grabbing the bottle, shaking it, and all of a sudden, right in this guy's face, I saw it in slow fucking motion. I'm like, oh, my bad. That's all
sorry,
I remember gonna say to myself. And I saw it, the bottle straight for his face.
Straight up sorry and shit.
Honestly, it was the fucking funniest thing of my life. But you know what? Fuck it.
Oh, that's great.
It was fucking hilarious. But no, I had never. This was the best experience of my life. But no, like I said, VIP, we had to do a weird rotation. They're like, alright, you have ICP, sign something for you. And then you go back in the back of the line, and then they'll take a picture with you.
What?
I was like, Jesus Christ, this sounds complicated. How come we just can't get the autograph and the picture? That just makes it easier. Then we can just all go inside and go have some fun. Nope, Meg is going to fucking line. I'm like, all right.
We're like Disneyland.
Right? It felt like Disneyland. I was like, well, shit, we are in Anaheim.
It's one of those things where you were saying that it was a toss-up because the artists were okay.
Yeah.
But just the way it was structured was
The way it was all handled, I could have felt it could have been handled a lot better where most of everybody could have had a better show.
Unfortunately, we didn't get to see Ouija Max set, but I actually got to at least catch up with him and actually, you know, talk with him for like a few, like, you know, minutes.
Mm-hmm.
He's actually super fucking cool. Super, like, down-to-earth dude, and, like, you know, just super chill.
He actually speaks to you, doesn't do
it. Yeah, he actually, looks at you in the face and talks to you. I'm like, okay, this motherfucker's actually chill. And then, like, no, and then I look at him, he's like, motherfucker, straight, and to be honest with you, I'm high as shit right now. He's high as fuck, too. I'm like, dude, he's actually super fucking cool.
Praise.
That's the same shit that Ritz did to me. He fucking pulled down his glasses when I went to...
he's like, you look like a brown me.
And he looked at me, he's like, what's your name? I said, Junior. I said, what's up, man? Chillest motherfucker ever.
That's bro. The funny thing is I can actually literally see him doing that exactly. Because looking at Riz, you can tell that motherfucker is straight up just chill.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Like, mostly, yeah, exactly. And the funny thing is meeting ICP in general, at least just doing the autograph signing in general, They were not like, okay, you, next, you know.
Yeah, they were actually
pretty chill. No. They straight up would be like, hey, how you doing, man? What's your name? They look at you in the fucking face, dude. I'm like, dude.
Yes.
And like, my first meeting, dude, was like, felt very personal, dude. I was like, damn, dude. I've looked up to you guys for so fucking long.
Yeah.
Like, for like, since I was a fucking kid, and now, like, I'm meeting you guys in general, and... The way meeting you guys is exactly how I wanted it kind of to go.
Mm-hmm.
And it actually was very personal. So I was like, you know what? I'm happy how that turned out. I'm like,
yeah,
you know,
that sounds chill.
They were so far the most laid back, more artists I would get like in your like personal mm-hmm. with you. They would ask you questions too, dude. They were like, you remember Slamfest with Attila?
Yeah.
Apparently he wants to make that even better. Violent J told me that personally because he actually asked me, he's like, when was the last time you saw us? I'm like, dude, the last time I saw you guys was literally a few months ago at Slamfest with you and Attila. He's like, oh shit, so just recently. I'm like, dude, you guys fucking killed that. He's like, I want to make that even bigger. I want to make that 10 times better.
I love that collaboration they had with that whole fucking
right, scene. And I want to see who they bring on board because that kind of shit would be so fucking sick. Especially what kind of metal band would they bring in?
Metal bands, just
maybe,
in general.
Maybe a metal band, anything, really. Because knowing ICP, they would bring some weird shit.
Considering fucking, it would be like a mini gathering, but fucking Slamfest style.
Right. Like, the one thing that's cool about ICP is because they have, like, either they can bring in, like, Attila and, like, all these other bands on board, or they get R.A. the Rugged Man, and, like, cool thing about it, too, is that he actually told us that Juggalo Day was going to be in New Orleans. Before that news even broke out.
Yeah, he told everybody.
He straight up said it, like, to me, too. Because
he
actually asked. He's like, I think someone behind me or two other people, like, oh, when's Juggalo Day? He's like, we're thinking of having it at New Orleans this year.
Nice.
And, dude, like I said, being out there with ICP is probably the most personal, like, I've ever felt with a group.
Very
and that was
even,
what I fucking
even,
liked.
Like, Gorilla Voltage? Because Gorilla Voltage...
Gorilla Voltage is another group that actually would talk to you.
Yeah, they're fine.
Because they're actually super cool, and me and them are actually chill too. Because I'm, you know, we met quite a few times, and we actually talked.
They're all like, we remember you guys.
They had like freaking. There's like, we have one video where you see him saying, "What's up?"
And he's getting a magic trick done by Brett.
Yeah, that's another funny one.
His whole face was just, the fuck.
But yeah, that's another one. And then the last show was the best. That's one of the crazy ones that I ended up getting for free.
You motherfucker, because that's the shit.
And I called him.
You get a 14 fucking free tickets. You get 4 fucking free tickets. You get 2 free tickets. You get 5 free tickets.
What are you doing, Tech? I want tickets.
Right.
I
couldn't go to Tech.
15 of my friends won fucking tickets.
And then I call him. I'm like, hey, dude, are you doing anything tonight? I'm like...
And then he tells me, I'm like, what if I fucking hunt? Why would you even tell me?
But I want to go, but money, but...
Right? It was a pretty dope show, I'm not going
to
lie.
Both me and him were doing the same thing. He even came to me, he was like, I have 4 free tickets for tomorrow. What do I do?
You want to go?
You want to go? Help me. And I'm like, dude, I can't. I got obligations.
Shit. I was trying to find a reason.
I know. So I was like, I ended up getting that day switched because I was supposed to close that day at my job.
Oh.
I ended up leaving, ended up going in the morning instead.
Nice.
That was a fucking night. And a fucking fight broke out outside. I'm watching this whole thing. It looks like World Star in front of me. I'm like, well, shit, I get to enjoy a tech show and a big fight. Yeah.
Wow. That's surprising. Yeah. It was at tech.
Right, dude, there, was no, it was between 40-year-olds and 20-year-olds. It was like older people.
Was it during tech set?
No, it was literally after the show. They all started fighting like from inside the venue all the way out into the fucking parking, like not in front, like at the floor, and then it was some stupid shit. I was like, oh my fucking god! And literally, the funny thing is, none of it was juggalos. Nothing. That was literally all like a 40-year-old like lady, like I don't know if she was in her 40s or something, and her like husband fighting these younger dudes and like girls. I'm like, dude, what the fuck? You guys are like acting like fucking children.
Yeah.
This was like a high school fight.
It's pretty bad when the juggalos are even looking at you.
They're all the juggalos are like this.
What?
We're all like, well,
what?
I know.
We're like, this is kind of sad. And then the funny thing is that the chick that's holding her purse is fighting, and then she holds her purse, and then she just grabs it.
She swung
it. No, she throws it off the second story. I'm like, what? I'm like looking. I'm like, wasn't that your purse? Nope, I guess not. Not anymore.
Fuck her.
And I think somebody ended up taking it. Dude, did someone just, like some random person that was walking just grabbed it and ran. I'm like, well, shit, you just threw your purse and you got it stolen.
Ooh, the purse, thank you, dude.
You technically gave it to them. Apparently she said it wasn't hers, but I'm like, weren't you holding it through the whole fight?
How drunk were you?
I'm like, I'm pretty sure that might have been yours, because you were holding it the whole time.
She wakes up in the morning.
Where's the purse? Somebody else's purse.
Yeah.
Fuck it, here. Throw your purse
away. I really feel like she did.
It was something. It was pretty funny. It was like all enjoyable.
But to think that would
be, it was kind of sad just watching these people fight. And okay. I'm like,
so
the vampire's watching you. All fighting like children.
So, what your age? Said,
I know, at your fucking age.
The openers for tech.
The openers for tech. I didn't seem futuristic, like, because I didn't get to go inside until later. But Dizzy Wright got to perform, so that was pretty fucking good.
Nice. Dizzy was good?
Okay. Yeah, Dizzy was actually good, so I'm not gonna lie. He actually got it pretty down, even though, like, sorry, Dizzy, I'm not gonna lie. You kind of remind me of, like a West Coast version of Wiz Khalifa.
Yeah.
I mean,
people would say that, actually. I've heard that around.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, but it's kind of true.
He's that underground version of Wiz, yeah.
Yeah.
Smoke spot.
Kind of sounds
raps a lot about pot.
It kind of sounds like it too.
Yeah. What's up, guys?
Yeah. I feel like they kind of look alike, maybe. I'm not sure. I'm like, which one's which?
He also reminds me a little bit of, like, Dizzy with his Golden Age project. It gave me a bit of a Pac vibe.
Oh, there you go. Right.
Just because his lyric content and, like, things he was saying in there.
Which were not all about pot.
Yeah, it just, I was like, okay, you talking about shit.
Okay, now this is the real talk this time. All right.
All right.
Yeah.
And no, that is true, yeah.
And Dizzy, so you...
He was pretty sick, though. He actually did a dope job.
Okay.
And then tech.
Whew. There was nothing else? There was no opener or anything?
No, nobody else, really.
Wow.
I didn't see anybody else, no.
That's a weird show for it to be, like... No opener or anything, and get them give away all those free tickets and shit.
Right? No, like we were thinking. I was telling you, like, and Brett about it too. You know, it's a dual message. I'm like, either like Strange Music is desperate or the House of Blues is desperate, and I'm pretty sure the House of Blues is desperate for tickets because now they're giving them away.
Well, not even that, but I bet you, like, they said you need this many heads in order to get whatever from the bar.
Yeah.
And so Tex was like, all right, I'll end up buying 200-some tickets and then passing them out, you know. And
hey, at least a rapper didn't pull a 50 cent on him.
Doing giveaways.
True. Just true. One fucking, who was that dude he used to beef with heavy?
Ja Rule. It was with Ja Rule that he did it with.
Tech. He used to
beef with
this one dude, another local Kansas City rapper.
Oh, I don't know.
It wasn't MGK. It was somebody else.
No, that's Eminem and MGK.
Yeah.
I think they're done. But none of them said shit lately.
This was like way back. He wrote he had a song on Celsius talking about him, and then,
I think I'm
not sure the name, though.
I know.
Yeah. But you were saying, like, that whole situation with the beef and everything, I think Tech has a little more standards now to where he just squashes the beef right there.
He doesn't beef. That's the thing. He doesn't want to bother.
He squashes beef right then and there now.
Okay, let's be honest. You know if you try to go up against Tech, he'll destroy the shit out of you.
That's why I forgot the name of the dude he had beef with. Who the fuck was he? Tech killed him. And then Don Juan, Tech killed him.
But yeah, that is true. Like, if you really think about it, like, okay, do you really want to go up against Tech?
No.
It's like, nah, just don't. It's like going up against Eminem, just don't.
Having a feature with him, you're already like, fuck.
Right? You're like, Jesus.
I gotta come home.
Exactly, bro. Like, I'm not the biggest Eminem fan, but I have the biggest respect for that motherfucker, because that motherfucker can drop, especially with after that song against MGK, I'm like, oh, fuck.
Killshot was
bro, I'm
surprised I was sick.
I am going to give credit to MGK, though, for wearing that shirt at his show. I'm going to give him credit for that. I'm like, well, shit.
At his opening for Fall Out Boy show.
Yeah, that's another thing. I'm like, you're opening up for Fall Out Boy.
Fall Out Boy is not too bad. They're good. They're a good band. They've been... Yeah. I like some of their...
Pop Rap Tour.
I can't. I'm one of those people that just couldn't do it. I couldn't.
So...
I'm like, during that whole, like, 2000, like late, like, early 2000s up until, like, the 2012 era, I couldn't get into that kind of shit, dude. Like, mostly, like...
The emo shit.
I can't. I fucking hated it.
Yeah. And then, so, you have Tech coming up. Tech came up and...
It fucking killed it. Unfortunately, they can't play Areola because of some stupid bitch.
Right.
Why?
She flashed, I think.
At a Tech show when she was 17.
Yeah, and her mom sued.
Because they ended up recording the show, and obviously, Tech doesn't hate when Chris Calico goes up, because obviously Chris Calico is like, he is a god to me. He's my favorite strange music artist.
He's one of those artists great. To me.
So fucking love Chris Calico.
I love him to death as a person, but I don't think he can have a full-on straight, you know, singles artist career. He always has to collab with somebody in order to make it.
Yeah, he's done good on his solo tours, that's all I can say.
He does good on his solo tours. Summer
of Strange
was good. But,
He headlined Summer of Strange.
Yeah.
That one was a good one.
That was the good one, yes.
Like, I'd be down for always come Chris Calico shit. I'm not gonna lie, Go was not my favorite album. I'm sorry, Chris. That was not the best.
I would agree.
And like a lot of people even said, too, that wasn't his best one either, because he did a lot of singing on it. I love his singing, but it wasn't that kind of album that he usually does, which is like a variety of different stuff that he had going on, you know?
Yeah.
Like, in every album that he has, he always has, like, a song that just sounds so different from the other.
And then...
That's what I love about Chris. But then later on, like, the whole...
Yeah.
Go album wasn't his thing.
And then... So you had your concert. Now... One thing I also did while working on was I got to participate in, the festival Demon Days. It's the Gorillaz festival. They had a bunch of R&B, jazz, hip hop, and then
that just sounds like a very nice variety,
right?
In a very weird way, it just sounds like a nice variety.
It was like that jazzy, that, you know, like a lot of places had that jazzy feel, and then you had that club scene,
right?
That was part of a lot of like hip hop. And then you had, like, it was segregated very well, because it wasn't like you were, it was at Pico Rivera in a sports center.
Okay.
So, it's very open spot, they had a lot of open space, but it was almost like they didn't utilize the space well enough, because it, like, there was, like, half of everybody that should have gone in a way, like, there was a lot of open room, and
it was kind of a redundant downer in a way when I'm walking around as a character and I'm like, it's like a wasteland. There's like nobody around and I'm like, wait, aren't there supposed to be people here? Like,
hello.
But people? Apparently they're all in the main stage night, or most of them were on like the main stage area. And also, anyway, so they also at this festival had LA.
Watch it. You're about to lose a leg.
LA Luchadors. LA Luchadors performed. It was alright. It wasn't the greatest. The storylines were a little redundantly out there, where they're trying to create a storyline without really there being a storyline.
They're just trying to create a story on the spot, but it's not going so great.
And yeah, exactly. Like,
I'm pregnant at your wife, and now I'm not the father.
So like bad improv.
Right? There was yeah, very bad. There was one match that I.
This is why you got rejected from acting class.
This is straight up, but this is one of those things where it was the funniest match ever, because you had the short little stubby guy with the skinny hot chick. And they're like, how?
It's like a TNA thing.
And then all of a sudden, you have the giant mastodon woman with the skinniest guy on the whole squad. And it was just like, wait a minute. Why? What? Huh? So none of it matched at all, but they tried to create something out of it. There was a dude that I fucking, like, wished I could have seen the whole match to. He was a Red Spider.
Red Spider?
Yeah, he was called Red Spider. He had, like, almost like the black, like, darker version of, like, a Spider-Man suit, but had, like, the black and red knee pads with it and everything. So it looked pretty sick, and I was like, God damn, this guy looks like he could do some damage. But I missed, like, most of their set because we had to go. What I was doing was I was being a marionette for the show, for the event, holding a post and walking people through the crowd. You'll see more of that because there's videos all over YouTube on that, and Instagram and shit, that I will be posting and will be getting, you'll see at the bottom.
Thank you, sir.
Also, what I was doing was like, doing intros and.
They didn't land on the cat. The cat's okay. Just landed next to the cat.
Cat didn't catch fire. We're good. Malenko didn't catch fire. But yeah, they had a.
They had
a sick pad because they took the bullfighting ring, I call it. Like, it was a straight up, like, concrete hole looking thing. With the tongue? What are you taking your tongue out for? Why you.
People, let me tell you about my best friend. She's a warm-hearted person who loved me till the end. People, let me tell you about my best friend. She's a one-boy cuddly toy. My up, my down, my pride and joy. People, let me tell you.
So, it was cool because, like, they had, like, the jazz part in, like, this bull ring. Like, it was a pit, and then there was seating around. And it was really awesome to hear, like, the bass and the drum from all the jazz stuff, like, going, like, echoing throughout this whole little area. But then you step outside of that area, and because it's concrete, it didn't echo as much. So, like, you walked out and you were hearing everything else instead of, like, really what was in that whole concert hall little place. And then they had, like, the festival out in the yard. And when I was doing my meet and greets and stuff, like, it was a wide variety of people. I even saw some juggalos. It was like a wide variety of juggalos, goth, hipster. But they were all chill with each other. Like, there was no beef. There was no.
So, like, how the world should be.
Exactly. It was, like, so chill. Right. And it made me appreciate the gorillas even more because they can do a festival and bring people together like that.
All right. So, major shout out to Tasty Creations, my homie, for these amazing vials, especially for the one I'm about to drink. Shout out to Ouija Mac, the amazing labels. You know, there's gonna be some good shit. It's gonna be starting. Get real nice. It just looks terrifying just even being poured in right now.
I thought you were doing it with Mountain Dew.
No, I'm not. Not this. Not the purple rain.
Purple rain.
Yes! That was the best thing! Jesus Christ. Oh god, that was the best thing ever.
That would be commercial status after the smoke.
Trademark this jingle right now.
Trademark it right now. Fat boy, give us credit, please. I love you, boy. Okay, I gotta do this slowly, because every time with this fucking syrup, if I can make this soda explode a little. I always have to be easy to see. See, you gotta be careful, because I poured it in last time, and it fucking made the whole go into... That's fucking weird, dude. I was like, Jesus fucking Christ, I just wasted the Sprite, but oh my god, it was good. Purple rain. Gonna explode. No, did not. Oh. Ooh.
Pretty much. Okay, so.
Yeah, let's keep on going. Like, oh yeah, like we were saying.
Moving on from that.
Well, we like, talked about
that whole, no, that whole purple rain. I'm gonna go off of that. Because that's what, like, the Gorillaz Festival was you had, like, songs like
we
that.
We had Purple Rain there, too.
All over the place. Well, no, I'm saying, like, I think, like, two people covered it, but, like, in different genre.
Ooh.
Like, one girl had, like, a Jamaican hip-hop, like, feel to it. It was very interesting.
A little bit of it later. You gotta do this shit easy, because Jesus Christ.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, no shit. This fucking shit explodes. Like a lot, like even just adding
explosion.
I'm just waiting for it just to like slowly calm down because it's the more you add, the more
dab.
It starts fizzing out and just
eats
on you.
I was dabbing on people in the haunt. They would go crazy. They'd be like, "Oh my god, he dabbed."
What? Yeah. What?
They're like, "Oh shit, the monster dab."
Dude. Okay.
He so did the dab.
He did the monster dab.
He did the dab. He did the monster dab. The monster dab.
We just created a new version, like a stupid version for Halloween. Updated yet old school yet. It's going to make everybody hate it. America.
It's going to go viral.
This fool, one night, I'm watching everybody congregate backstage by the TV screen that show each room.
And the back room where they all see them haunting.
And they're all watching us. And all of a sudden, I'm noticing all of them busting up laughing. There's like maybe 8 people just watching him work. And he's in his room, fucking shirt off. He's got painted areolas and total like pulled the red jumpsuit. Yeah, the jumpsuit short.
They
made him shorts. He's running around going. Shuffle,
ability to on you.
That was on Halloween.
He was going.
Do you feel this on you?
I was just seeing him doing it. I'm like, oh
do
dear
feel
God.
It?
It was so much fun on Halloween night.
You were having fun.
I lactated on my friends. I asked my mom to breast.
For the breast of us?
For her to get breastfed by me. It was me returning the favor. I would whisper.
Bro, you're paying forward.
Pretty
much.
Yeah, very sick way.
Paying forward.
Yep. I would whisper in ears saying, can I wear your skin? Please, mom, can I wear your skin? Screaming and peeing all over themselves. Such a beautiful night. Halloween night.
It was fun. That was a beautiful night.
It was a beautiful night.
Your fucking face was great the whole night because you were just like, I don't know how I did that, but it happened. The whole rest of the night, you was just like, wait, I totally got away with that. How the fuck did that happen?
Fat boy, no lie, your shit makes sodas explode, and Jesus Christ, I'm just gonna cast some of that syrup in there.
Just save it, bro. Save it.
Delicious.
Alright, but.
Like,
and
like a little try of that scissor.
Man, I'll feed them.
That's apparently it tastes good. Apparently,
you know what? If we're gonna give him a good one, then you know what? We're gonna put some of that good in there too. You know what?
So there we go. Oh!
Some of that three tile.
The three tile.
That three tile. There you go, bro. Did you get to try some of that deliciousness from Fat Boy? You know what? Tasty High, thank you for everything. Especially that major hookup.
Thank you, Fago. Thank you, Sprite. You do what's right.
Oh!
No lie, dude. He has a good flavor. So far, my favorite flavor that you came out with was the fucking blue raspberry lemonade one. That was my favorite.
Better try this one. Try that.
Yes.
That's a dry creation. It's like maple syrup.
Tastes like maple fucking syrup.
That just tastes like amazingness.
Do you want to taste maple syrup?
Yes.
Yeah, I want to taste it.
I know, right? Try. Everyone try. Shannon.
Shannon.
Is that like someone with a stutter trying to say your name?
Okay. I think I just became a Fango fan. It's the first time.
All of a sudden, you see face paint on his face slowly.
It wouldn't be the first time.
That is just like, that's dangerous. Holy
so
shit.
Delicious. Oh my god.
When you're in my house, you're gonna get high shit.
High shit.
For all you Facebook fools that be talking shit, saying you got the hot good shit, come at my house. There you go. I have spoken.
Right.
Especially you, Trilo, you fucking Florida shit.
Oh.
Sorry.
Colin, I out.
He knows I love him. I'm sorry, but I smoke Florida weed. I know this is weird. It didn't taste right.
It
didn't taste right, bro. It didn't taste the same.
That Arkansas weed.
How is it? Not the same.
So their top shelf was our swag.
No shit.
It was terrible.
Oh god.
And that was
road trip.
Yeah. We'll have some fun next time.
Right?
Just
it doesn't have to make sense. It's beautiful. Take it. Thank you. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you.
I'll give you the queen wave.
Queen wave. Alright. Peace out, guys.
He's blocking my face.
Adios. Hello?
That was a weird threesome.
Like, I don't know whether to be aroused or disturbed.
It may have been a weird threesome, but it was a free.
It was free.
It's a
there you go.
It still involved three.
Yeah.
Three.
Three threes.
There you go. New porn genre. All by itself. Free threes.
Damn, how are you? Yo, I play Legend of Dr. Octopus once, and it's a simulator game, man. And it's like you grab your lightsabers, and you cut fruit. It's the new advanced version of fucking ninja cuts fruit. And a ninja one time told me something about cutting fruit. The ninja was like, "Junior, look at me in the ojos." I looked at him right in the ojos. And I was like, "Yes, Mr. Ninja."
Hit it. Take it to the head. Make it your bitch. There we go. Right on my head.
Can you finish it?
Shannon! He needs you. Take his head.
Into the rest.
I'll take. Oh god, he's dying. Hold on.
Okay.
Yeah,
you good, CJ? You want some Fago?
Blue.
Give me blue.
Give me the blue.
Mountain Dew.
I need blue.
Thank you, sir. No problem, sir.
That was part of the outtakes. Sorry, bro. We're gonna. It's a like capturing moment.
Oh, right? I'm dying.
Yeah.
Your fucking weed killed him.
I'm so sorry. I have the strong homegirl. I wish it was
that shit
by
lit.
My
that shit lit.
That shit real lit.
My cousin hooked it up.
I'm feeling
gracias,
that.
Primo.
Holy
gracias.
Fuck.